Hey people, welcome to Dots and Moms Kitchen. My name is Kavita and in today's video I'm going to share how to make banana appam. I generally share baby and kids food recipes only on my channel, not something very generic, because when I talk about kid friendly, it needs to be something which does not take too much of a time of a parent, because they are already running short of time. So it needs to be healthy, it needs to be time saving, it needs to be something which requires minimum ingredients. So this banana appam is a South Indian recipe. Most parts of Kerala and Mangalore this is made, and now I'm using jaggery in this, which is an advantage, and banana and wheat flour are easily available at your home. So let's dive right in and see how to make it. To begin with, in a bowl, I'm taking well-ripe banana. These are bigger versions of bananas. That is the one which you can use. Kerala banana also some people may like, but I'm not sure how the taste it would turn out to be. Now I'm adding jaggery powder. At Tots and Mom store, you can purchase this, or you can just, grate any normal jaggery you have and add it here. Mix it well and it would look something like this. Once it is dissolved well with banana, then I am adding wheat flour, about 1 cup. I am now adding rice flour, about 1 tablespoon, and this is freshly grated coconut, 1/4 cup. Completely optional, but trust me, this adds lot of taste value to this recipe, so do not miss it. Cardamom powder a pinch, salt a pinch or as needed, and baking soda just a pinch. Now, milk is something that I cannot tell you how much you would need exactly, because it depends on the flour you have used. So keep mixing it and then add it as and when required. The consistency should be thicker than idli batter, slightly thicker than idli batter, as you can see in here. Now the batter is ready. It's time to cook our appam now in the appe pan. Appe pan is hot, and now we will start pouring in ghee to each holes, and then I'm adding a spoonful of batter to each. When you fill in any cavity, ensure that you don't overflow the batter, because it would fluff up a bit. Once done, 5 minutes one side, the first time it would take, otherwise it would look uncooked inside and kids would really not like something very chewy. So it's good to cook it well. Turn it and cook it on both the side. I'll also leave the link for appe pan in the description box. You can have a look in case you want to purchase this. And our banana appam are all ready. You can put this into snack box or serve it hot. Instead of giving any junk food, if you give a lot of healthy varieties, kids would really love it. I hope you like this recipe. There are plenty of these sort of snack recipe on our channel. I'll leave below the link in the description box. The ingredients which I have used are mentioned in the description and also there on the blog. So do check them. And yes, I'll see you soon in yet another video. Till then, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.